sometimes bad offense turns into good offense, good offense for the other team. So disappointed third quarter. I think that's where they got their edge.
You look at offense and defense as being completely separate, or do you think one...
No, they're related, being obviously taking care of the ball, so it's important. Shot selection is huge. I thought we settled, we started playing, too much one-on-one. That's not our game. Then they got out and, got in transition, got some good looks. Murray, obviously, made some good shots for them, so...
D'Angelo struggled shooting from the floor, a little bit of foul trouble. What are you noticing from them?
Yeah, I think, collectively I said it before the game, it's a collective team effort, and we have to be clicking on all cylinders for us to be good. I thought he had some good looks, but didn't go down.
Going back to that the third quarter, I mean, understanding that you have some pieces out, some significant veteran pieces that are missing, a 25-2 run, is that the kind of situation where veteran leadership kind of turns off the spigot and doesn't let that become, stops it at whatever, 12-2, 13-2, but not 25-2? Is that
leadership? I felt the, not to hark on last season, but a little bit like last season, we didn't have the maturity that happens in the NBA. I mean, I get they have a lot of talented players, and they made a run. And I think we called a couple of timeouts. We tried to get it back, but we just never responded. And then we never responded, and then we kind of wilted. And we needed better leadership at that time. But, it's up to our young guys, too. I think it's on them to learn from this and get better from it. But, we didn't respond at all.
Anyone else?
Obviously, if D'Angelo's out there, he's going to say, I'm healthy, because I'm out there, I'm playing, so I'm healthy. I'm just curious, to my eyes, it looks like since the Orlando game, when he got tweaked, when he had the knee tweak, he just hasn't looked quite the same. In your mind, is he 100%? And if he is 100%, is there something where he's maybe mentally not back to where he...
We wouldn't put him out there, Brian, if he wasn't 100%. We obviously, our medical team and him, we do this collaboratively. So, he's fine. I do think this is every NBA player, and I think other sports too, when you have a little injury, it takes you a little time to get your rhythm, to just get it back, and I'm sure he's searching for it. He'll get it back. I mean, he started the season, really strong, and, got dinged up a little, I think it's a question of rhythm.
In terms of, you said that during that stretch, there wasn't the leadership that you were looking for, like breaks on it. Where are you looking for that to come from?
I look, obviously Damari's a big part of it, but I also think we have, guys that have been here, Karis and even D'Angelo, like those guys, that's part of the growth process. We just don't look at leadership from you have to be, 35 years old to be a leader. Like, you can be a leader when you're 22 or 24. So I think we'll have a good discussion about it. And what happens, I think, sometimes with Brian said, they make a run like that, you just kind of lose your principles. You don't stick to your habits. And I felt like our habits just went out the window. So some of that is guys who haven't been here, for a while, just the habits aren't ingrained enough. But I think leadership can not only come from the veteran guys, and come from the younger guys too.
Okay, guys, thank you.
Thank you.